That felt like I was standing on a soapbox, just making some noise about the reality of what's going on. And this month on the 18th is Anti-Slavery Day, so we're going to be putting out as a film later this month, but this is called The Girl in Chains. It was the promise of new paradise, finance and married life, carried from strife, angry nights, drunken fights, a corrupt way of life. Compromised by his trusting eyes, she dreams to find freedom. Telling the tales of a better place, more money and somewhere safe for her, replaced by an act of grace. The broken smile on her face, his open arms and expensive taste. Her heart begins to race for freedom. Now she was shipped to unknown waters, left one son and three daughters, and she said, "You know how much I love you. How much I'm gonna miss you in your dreams. I'll kiss you and strike every single night of my life. I'm trying to bring you freedom." But the man that she had trusted wasn't there for her customs. Three men took her hand and they led her to her dungeon. Gave her filthy linen, took her passport, and threw her into a room of around 50 women where she was mistreated, beaten, and kept like a dirty secret. And they brought her in to sleep with, taught her every weakness. And through the trauma and tears, the horror and fears, every night she calls out praying that God still hears. Cause in the morning, when the sun's breaking, her body starts shaking. The fact she's waking means those nightmares weren't nightmares. And dreams of escaping were just a heart making promises that kept breaking. See, I thought I knew what fear was, but imagine kneeling in a dungeon with a 6'5", 300-pound man telling you to touch him like he's your husband and he doesn't know your name. All he knows is your price tag, and all you know is the pain, the shame, and the life that he might have. And there's no honor you can claim, and there's no way that you can fight back, so you just lie flat on stained covers, watching on back at nightcap, and pray that your pain is an escape for another sister, daughter, mother, any other held captive by man's animalistic habits. Men I don't respect pimps, I spit upon what they practice, I spit upon any industry that tries to destroy intimacy. When it's your sister getting caught a bitch, you start to see it differently. It's interesting how these men don't understand, man. The fact you have a penis doesn't mean that you're a man. Because there's still over 30 million slaves today. And some don't even have a double figure for their age. And if that doesn't riddle you with rage, you gotta check your heart still beating in the middle of your cage. And don't let ignorance ignore it. And don't let a ludicrous lust support it. How can we enjoy life when they just endure it? Man, if we're going into battle, then I'm for it. See, we thought we separated ourselves from the gates of hell. But it's just down the road they swap, trade, and sell innocent women and children. Punished and put in prisons like the criminal system. So we're coming to the dungeon to deliver the victims to finish the image that man is, the image that man is pictured of women. You can catch a late at night on the television screens or on the top shelves in them dirty magazines. And she screams on the internet, crying for help, destructing herself. And yet the only men watching are the ones touching themselves. Brother, you're kidding yourself. These women are stolen, either from their homes or from knowing that they're golden. So I'm exposing how lost conviction and character. Man, how low are we going believing it's a natural factor for any husband, father, boyfriend, brother, or bachelor to watch captured sex slaves like they are Hollywood actors? That's why I'm clutching the hand of any woman sex trafficked or scammed and saying, you are not an object of sex or demand. You are the beloved. Beloved and understanding that will start the march and the battle through the heart of this man. Thank you very much.